Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. In part 10 of the Image Toolset series, you'll learn about the flexibility you have when it comes to combining your masks with other constraints within a selective. So you may be using an external mat, a Kia, a 3D AOV, or even a combination, and you can use a mask in multiple ways to refine the selective even further. If you are new to selectives, please watch from the start of the series to familiarize yourself with how to use them. To follow along with this video, use any of your own media and apply a selective with the selective effects to a shot. For example, all I have done is applied a selective to some footage and I have keyed the image with the diamond keyer. You could use any of the other keyers, including the new semantic keyer, and this will also work with the 3D AOVs if you're using them on your shot. You can see the mat in the selective view in the middle, and this is driving a bloom selective effects, which you can see in the result view on the right. Now let's say you wanted to limit the selective mat to just the side panel. You could do this with the mask spline. Select and expand the selective in the manager, and add a mask using the context menu. Hover over the selective view and press F8 to see the object view for the new mask. Now go ahead and draw a mask around the side paneling. When you switch back to the selective view with F9, you can see that the contents of the mat are now limited by the mask. So the default behavior of a mask when it comes to the selective is to limit an existing mat. But in the Flame 2020.1 update, it is possible to change this blending behavior. For example, select the existing mask and delete it. Now let's say that you want to surgically remove or add additional parts to the mat instead of constraining the contents with the mask. So let's remove this upholstery section at the top. As before, you add a mask to the selective. Now draw the mask around the area you'd like to remove. So the mask is currently constraining the contents of the mat. To change this behavior, select the selective and go to the selective controls. Under the input mat and G mask, you will see a blending pull-down menu. This controls the overall mask blending in the selective. If you change the blending mode to add, this will fill the mask with white, and the rest of the mat will return. This is great for filling holes up in the mat that could not be done with a key or a 3D AOV. And the same thing goes for removing content as well. Setting the pull-down menu to multiply will fill the mask with black, and you can knock out certain parts of the mat you don't want. This is a global mask blending mode within the selective. So if you were to add another G mask to the selective, switch to the object view with F8, and mask out another part of the image, this mask will also be filled with black. You can switch back to the selective view with F9 to see the selective mat combined with the masks. Changing the blending mode at any point will affect all masks associated with the current selective. So those are the three options you have to control the way masks behave within the selective pipeline. You can constrain a mat, add more detail to the mat, or remove the detail from the mat depending on the input mask blending modes. Don't forget to check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to the Flame 2020.1 update. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.